What is your take on MBBS versus BDS?
See, honestly, doctor, what I have seen is the legacy follows.
But what if you're a first generation medico?
If you are looking for a correct return on investment, then there is no better options than dentistry.
What would be your priority?
First, you should look at the course, then the college.
Any advice for people who want to take up BDS or who are confused whether they should or should not?
See, dentistry is not science and art. Dentistry is rather art and science.
Okay. Sir, talking about colleges now, I want to understand what are the parameters to look at when you're choosing a college for MBBS and for BDS?
See, MBBS and BDS, the parameter, first and foremost thing is your NEET score. And because the college will be allotted as per your NEET score. Of course, the choice is yours. You don't want to put government college at number one option, then definitely you are not going to get that option allotted. While making the choices, in fact, I would rather say the most important thing is the prioritization of the choices. You have to prioritize your colleges or institutes while doing the option entry. Now, 99% of the students, they don't know about the colleges because it is not practically possible for a person to visit each and every college. Even if you are from a particular state, even if you are from Maharashtra, it is not possible for you to visit all the deemed universities and all the colleges. Correct?
We did 15 to 17 colleges, but it was hard. Like, we had to go four colleges in a day to cover up that one entire area of.
In our time, we used to hear and go because internet was not in power. Now, internet is in power. If you can't do something by yourself, you have to find a person who can do it on your behalf. You have to find an experienced person who have seen all those things and who can guide you. Now, you can ask, coming back to your question, what are the parameters? Of course, the parameters are there. One, what type of group is running the institution?
Okay.
Are they into the education field from earlier? Do they have any that kind of background? Because if they have that kind of background, then means they are not entering a new segment.
Okay.
They are just expanding this. Yeah, they are just expanding the segment. So definitely, that is one point. Point number two is the location of the college.
Okay.
Because as per the location, the number of OPD, the OPD will depend upon the location.
Okay.
What is the use of a college? If you are getting only the academic qualification and you are not getting a practical experience. Practical experience will depend upon the number of OPDs and your hands-on. It is directly proportional to each other. Number three, age of the institution. The older the college, you will find the old fraternity, older
alumni.
Means not alumni, but the professors.
Okay.
Because they will, they would like to continue in the same college, mostly. They can give the student a better academic experience. So this all are some basic things. If a you might have heard that if you open a garage on the third floor, then how will it go? So, if a medical college is in such a location where there is nothing 15 km, 20 km, then patient will come. But it will take 20 years of time, or 10 years, or 15 years, or 20 years of time, for that area to develop.
True.
then you will start getting the patient. Unless and until there is a miracle.
A patient also has to trust the doctors, right? So it's going to take time over the course of years. We have to look at it from the patient side also.
Yes. See, patient, consider the patients as a layman. The patients who goes to medical colleges or dental institutes to get the treatment done are 90% of them are from villages or the person who cannot afford that much.
Sure.
What they will look? Infrastructure.
Okay.
Agar infrastructure acha hai, matlab yahan treatment acha hota hoga. Acha hospital hai, hospital acha hai. They don't know much. Now, if your college is new, if the infrastructure is not that great, if the location is relatively outskirts, the patient will be apprehensive to come there. That is why we always consider the age of the institution. So these are some basic plus. Many students are the alumni of many reputed medical colleges. So, if you are from reputed medical colleges or dental colleges, then you get the same fraternity or the same alumni somewhere. The benefit will not come, the benefit of networking will not tell you income. It will come all as an instance. Right? So, there are many basic things which people don't look upon or people don't pay attention to, but these all are very important.
And all of this is directly proportional to what kind of medical graduate you will become 5 years down the line. And to be very honest, you are not the same person. So when you are 18 or 19, you are very naive.
Correct.
But when you go to a college and you meet the right people and you meet, you know, a different surrounding, your 11th and 12th is just book, say, padho, classes, job and everything. Mm. But things change after you go to a college. And your college really defines how your personality becomes, which will define how your career is.
Definitely.
So once they are done understanding the course and the college finances, all of these things that are sorted, if we can get a few tips on how to sort of fill the counseling form, how to go about things through the process.
See, there are lots of complicated points while doing the counseling for each and every state. All the different states has different counseling procedures and rules and regulations, right? It is not practically possible for a person to attend counseling of all the states unless and until he reads the brochure of each and every state 2-3 times. Because there will be some point which they have not put in bold letters and it will be overlooked by you. Because you have to read this state ke bhi 50 panne padne, information brochure ke, us state ke bhi 50 panne padne, us state ke bhi 50 panne padne, and then you have to make points. These are the important points here, these are the important points in this state, these are the important points in this state.
But domicile nahi hoga, nobody can practically have every state, right?
Most of these states are open state in India.
Okay.
Even if you are from Maharashtra, you can take admission in Karnataka, you can take admission in Haryana, you can go to Rajasthan, you can go to Kerala, you can go to Tamil Nadu, you can go to Andhra Pradesh, okay. Wherever you want.
Oh, okay, I didn't know that.
Yeah, many states are closed states.
State counseling because everybody was applying for it, but other states we didn't know about.
Here comes the role of guidance.
I distinctly remember coming to Bangalore, you know, in that havoc, in that big building, and it was really a pain.
It was like that.
Yes. So, I'm going to share a very funny experience. When I was applying for counseling, there was this one company who came and said that we will take your fingerprint.
Mm-hmm.
And by mapping your fingerprint, we are going to tell you what your brain and your development looks like. And we will tell you the exact course you should get into. I had done this after my 10th standard, just to understand whether I should take what I am actually taking.